Okay, so in this next video, I'm going to talk about how matrix algebra, specifically how we define the matrix product, speaks of linear systems of equations. And so we started with the idea that a fundamental equation for matrix algebra is A times X is equal to B vector, where A is in R M by N, X is in R N, and B is in R M. Okay, this is too complicated. We just started. Let's take the following idea. Let's say M is equal to 1, N is equal to 1. Then we have that little a, which is a scalar, right, times X is equal to B. And then the goal is to find X. Alright, this is all just scalar math now, stuff we've been doing for practically our whole lives. Maybe not in an abstract sense, but right, figuring out the unknown, at least since we were in the double digits. And so, one would think that X is equal to B over A. B over A, which is true, provided that A is not equal to 0. Right? If A is equal to 0, then two things could happen. Thing one, if B is not equal to 0, then there are no solutions, right? Because what does the equation look like? It really looks like 0 times X is equal to B, which is not 0. And so there's no X that can satisfy this equation, right? Well, if B is equal to 0, then 0 times X is equal to B, which is 0, and any X satisfies this equation. Right. And so what we get into here is there's this idea of a trichotomy of outcomes. No solutions exist. A solution exists, but the solution is not unique. What is meant by this is, like, if you put a 2 right there, well, 0 times 2 is equal to 0, that's fine, but you could also put a 3 right there. There are, in fact, infinitely many solutions that you could put there, and that's where this non-uniqueness comes from. And this says that a solution exists, and there is only one solution. Right, so it exists and it is unique. So, that's the scalar case. Anytime we get to something of high dimension, then we can always just think about the scalar case and see if there's any sort of insight we can gain from that. Well, let's do another example and make this more geometric. For this example, let's consider the A matrix to be equal to little a, little b, little c, little d. Let's consider the x vector to be equal to xy. And let's consider consider the B vector to be equal to B1 and B2. Then, the equation A times X is equal to, well, I can take A and I can multiply it onto X because there are two columns of the A matrix and two rows in the X vector. The result should be, well, if there's two columns in the A matrix and two rows in the X vector, the result should be the number of rows in A, which is 2, times the number of columns in B, which is 1. So the result should be a 2 by 1. That 2 by 1 is A times X plus B times Y. And the first component, so this is just two rows, one column, then CX plus DY in the second. And then I have B1 and B2 on the right-hand side. So this is really, anytime we start increasing dimension, now what we're talking about is many equations. Well, because of the way matrix multiplication is defined, let's take a look at these equations on the left in particular. I'm talking about these right here. What we want to notice is X is being raised to the first power, Y is being raised to the first power, they're multiplying constants and they're added together. So we have AX plus BY is equal to B1, and CX plus DY is equal to B2. Right? Or Y of X is equal to B1 over A, or over B minus A over BX, and let's call that Y. Let's just call that Y. Another equation for Y is going to be Y is equal to B2 over D minus CX over D. And so what we see here is that these are the equations of two models. And so, to solve this original equation, A times X is equal to the B vector, we have to make both of these equations simultaneously true, which is the same as saying, hey, both of these equations here have to be equal. Well, if both of these equations are equal, we're looking at shared Y values. Well, if we have shared Y values, there should also be a shared X value, and so, the problem is, now phrased is find all points in the xy plane where these two lines intersect. That's the geometric problem. Find all xy in R2 where these lines intersect. That's what the problem means geometrically, and what we see from that is that, here, I'll grab two oranges, then what we see from this is that we again get the trichotomy, right? How can two lines in space be arranged? If these were two lines, well, and I made them parallel, then they would never intersect, right? That would be the case of no solutions from the scalar example. I could set the lines up so that they were like this, so that there would be one point of intersection between the two. That would be one set of xy, one point, such that both equations were simultaneously true. Right? Or I could make them collinear, right, so that both lines are touching all the time, and that would be infinitely many points in the direction of this line, for the, such that both lines... both equations are simultaneously true. So we again see that trichotomy, and geometrically what this is representing here is the idea of intersections of linear things in space. Here we have lines in the plane. To make our life easier, let's go up here really quick. Suppose that B1 is equal to B2, which is equal to 0. What that would do for each of the lines, right, we see it right here. Is that those components would go away. Well, what those components mean geometrically is the y-intercept, right? So what we demand now is the implication here is that both lines pass through 0, 0. So they're guaranteed to intersect. They're both going through the origin of the coordinate system. Now the question is, are there more points of intersection? Well, there's definitely the 0, 0 solution, but if we want the lines to intersect at more points, then they, well, what would happen? They have to go through the origin, so say the origin is this black dot right underneath these pens right here. Well, they intersect at that black dot, and the only way to get more points of intersection is to align this line with the other, right? And so what they would share then is the same slope. They would both have to have the same slope if we were going to have more points of intersection. So if we want the lines to intersect at more points, then they must have the same slope. So the implication is that A over B with a negative must be equal to negative C over D. Or if I multiply both sides by D and B, I get negative AD is equal to negative CB. Or if I move this AD over to the right, I'll have that 0 is equal to AD minus BC. And that's a known quantity. That is something that we've seen in Calc 3. It's a determinant calculation, and that is the determinant of the A matrix. So, this is our key point. A times X is equal to, not B, well it was B, but really what we said was make everything intersect at the origin. So A times X is equal to 0 has non-zero solutions if the determinant of A is equal to 0. And that's the key point. This describes, for 2x2 matrices, lines going through the origin. So X being 0 is guaranteed to solve this problem. Right? If you want more points in space where they intersect other than just X is equal to 0, then you're going to have to set the determinant of the A matrix equal to 0. These non-zero solutions are called non-trivial solutions. The zero solution is called the trivial solution.